today is about giving back at this time of the year. And so it's going to be kind of a haphazard thing, but we've got a lot to do today, so bear with me. So Donna's going to help me here today, but the first organization that I'd like to recognize and call up is a representative from whoever from AEW would like to come up. Maybe it's Gordy, maybe, I'm not sure. Would you please come up? And so I reached out to, by the way, AEW, for those of you who don't know AEW, I've been working with these guys for a long time now. They are everywhere in the county. You almost can't get rid of these guys. But I'm going to tell you, they're a great organization, and they have, I've worked with Gordy and other people from AEW through the years. They're always giving back. They're always supporting the community. It's a really great company. Thank you all for what you do. And you have a presentation today from AEW to the new Baltimore Lions Club. And so I think there's a representative from the Lions Club here today, Laura, if you'll come up. And so they have a check for their upcoming event here, their Winter Festival. And Laura's a councilwoman in New Baltimore, and also, too, she works with the Lions Club. Great organization, Lions Club. $750 for the Lions Club.
Wow, thank you.
Very good. All right. And then, thanks. And then next, and I'll actually give you the real checks before you leave here today.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So they are out there someplace. And then the other organization I wanted to recognize today in terms of their community support. And so of Kevin Abdallah from Cloud Cannabis, and many of you know Kevin, besides being in the cannabis business, he's Juan Miguel's. Kevin, are you around here or did you go? Kevin Abdallah? He is out there? Kevin, come on in. Come on up here. Okay. So many of you have eaten at Kevin's establishment, Juan Miguel's, but Kevin and his new ventures and Juan Miguel always giving back. And so Kevin has today here on behalf of his organization. We're giving here, hold on just a second. Oh, yeah, there you go. $500 to the New Baltimore Civic Club. Dave Duffy, if you'll come up here. Many of you know Dave from the Civic Club. And then in addition, and I guess Laura's going to have to come back up again. Kevin's got a check today for $750 for the, $1,000, I'm sorry, for the New Baltimore Lions Club. So another $1,000 for the Lions Club. Yeah. Thank you, Kevin. And Kevin is one of the Chamber's biggest supporters and always helping out. He never says no. And I love Kevin. He's like a brother to me.
Thank you.
And I really appreciate his friendship. Thank you, Kevin.
Yeah. Thank you, John.
Yeah. And then next, we have a couple of checks to present. So if Bo Marasco and Mark Abraham from Venco would come up here, if you would, please. Money, you know, Bo and Mark. And so Bo and Mark are in a lot of different business ventures, but primarily they're partners in Venco. And Venco is a cannabis operation, but Bo has a business here in Clinton Township called Protein Corporation, and they work a lot with Ford Motor Company, do all their displays. And Mark has Mack Freight. And so today what we're going to do is Bo, there are two cruises, that would be the Warren Cruise and the North Gratiot Cruise. Bo is the guy that cooked hamburgers and hot dogs and set it all up and did it all on himself. I've gotten to know Bo really well. He's a really wonderful, caring, giving, loving person. I appreciate his friendship. But he raised for McRest $3,000. Yeah. And then Mark came to me recently and, hey, Dave, can you come up, Dave, from Vets Returning Home? Yeah, and one of you guys had the check for Vets. Yeah, okay, very good. And so I talked to Mark recently, and Vets Returning Home is a homeless shelter in Roseville, and they serve veterans, as the name would indicate, and they do a really great job. And Sandy, the founder, is unable to be here today. She's got COVID, unfortunately. But if we ever owe a debt of gratitude to anybody, it's our service people. I'm sorry in some ways that I never served, but I really appreciate what what they did and, you know, how they served our country. And so Mark is a former veteran himself, and he said, I want to do something to help out the vets. And so we talked about it. You've established a program now for vets returning home, and maybe you'd like to speak to that.
Yes. Thank you, John. We've wanted to get involved in this program since we met Sandy a long time ago. COVID kind of sidetracked us, but we're now back on track. And like we've done in the past with our trucking industry, trying to not just have something that we can give, but something that keeps on going. So the people in our organization at Venco have decided that, you know, not decided, but we've discussed, you know, some sort of a continuing program that we're going to have, and everybody is just going to chip in. We just take little pieces of payroll, not enough that it hurts anybody, but at the end of the day, when we put enough people together and enough dimes and nickels, it turns into real money, and I'm proud of that. I'm a veteran, and changed my life. I'm a much better person for it, and so, and John's kind of, you know, introduced us to the right people that have given us an avenue to finally be able to do some things and give back. So we're proud of it. Thank you, John, for everything.
So you have a check, first down payment to Vets Returning Home today, Dave from Vets Returning Home. Wow. Dave's the chef at Vets Returning Home, and an old friend of mine, actually, for many, many years. But the first payment to the Vets Returning Home, $2,000, and part of an ongoing program. And so I said a lot of great things about Bo, and but Mark, his partner, wonderful human being in his own right, a great supporter of mine and this organization, and heart's in the right place. Always first to step up and lead the way. Thank you, Mark, for what you do as well. God bless you, brother.
Thank you, John. Yeah, appreciate you.
Well, thank you, guys. And then next today, the Warren Community Foundation. So the Warren Community Foundation, we held our 5K and our cruise in Warren this past June. And many of the of our board members are here today. Bob Bonkowski's here with us to help also to Tracy Antrikin. Let's see who else is here today that we, I might recognize. Of course, Donna, everybody knows Donna. Donna is, listen. Yeah, Donna is the person that makes it really happen. But so we did have an event here recently where we gave out the proceeds of that event at the Warren Chamber Luncheon, but there was a few people who couldn't make it that day, and there was some residual left over. And so today we want to kind of finish things off. And so if Dennis Champagne will come up from Centerline. Dennis, if you'll come up. Are you here, Dennis? I think so. And so the Warren Community Foundation, the Cruise in 53, the Warren 5K worked real closely with Centerline. And Dennis is the city manager there. So Dennis and I, actually, we've known each other maybe 30 years. I don't know, a long time. Warren, back to the days of Warren. Well, yeah, a long time. And now he's over at Centerline. But it was kind of a joint venture, an adventure, the cruise. And this was our second year of having done it. But it was such a pleasure to work with the people from Centerline and the city manager. Dennis is one of the, you know, I've said this before, I hope you take it in the van, but he's one of the greatest city managers around. This guy's really on it and really committed and really making a difference. I admire Dennis a great deal. But so Centerline share, we're donating to the Centerline Festival Foundation today, which does great things in their community. We're giving them $2,000 today. Dennis, would you like to take more? And his boss, the mayor, Bob Benson, is here today. And Bob did a great job picking, but Bob's the real brains behind the operation. So, yeah. And anyway, okay. And then next for proceeds from the Warren Community Foundation today, we want to honor Harvest Time Ministries. And Pastor Ostash, if you'll come up. And this wouldn't be the first time we did this with Harvest Time this year, but Pastor Ostash is the pastor of a congregation on the south end of Warren, yeah. 9 Mile.
Nice has, Van Dyke.
Yeah, has a food pantry there, does a lot of great stuff in the community. Frontline guy on it every day, making a difference in the lives of people, feeding lots of people. How many people do you feed?
Last month we had 1,800 people come through our food pantry. Give out around 70,000 pounds of food a month, and we've been doing it for 30 years. It's a labor of love. We have no paid staff. Nobody on our staff is paid. Everybody does it because they volunteer, including myself, and want to be there and want to bless the community. The south end of Warren's the poorest zip code in all of Macomb County. So there's a lot of need, and we've been there for 30 years meeting that need.
So today, $2,000 from the Warren Community Foundation to Harvest Time Ministry. Thank you for what you do. God bless you.
Thank you.
Yeah, you bet. And then next today, I wanted to recognize through the Warren Community Foundation, if I could, AnnMarie Ottoy from East Point, if you'll come up. Oh, you're right here, actually. It's all good. And so I've gotten to know the mayor fairly well here over the last year or so, and she's committed to the homeless community herself and a lot of community causes, actually. And we had a nice long chat the other evening about serving and leading and making a difference. And she is doing exactly that. And she established an organization this past year, and we helped her. Brad did all the filings for a nonprofit and the like, but homeless to homeowner. And so we wanted to make a contribution today to homeless to homeowners for $1,000. Thank you, Brad. Would you like to say something?
Good afternoon, everyone. There we go. Wake up. So I want to say, first of all, thank you for that check and helping me to help other people. I know a lot of us probably never experienced homelessness. There's someone in here that has. Mr. Benson has. Anybody else has experienced homelessness? Know someone that has, going through it. If you lost your job, CEO position today, would you be able to pay your mortgage? You would be homeless too. That's how important this is. During COVID-19, a lot more people have been homeless. They have good jobs. They have experience, knowledge, and some of them have titles. And they have lost their jobs, lost homes. And you can't even, as a real estate agent myself, I can't half the time find someone a home because it has hiked in pricing. A two-bedroom house with a bathroom, they want $100,000 for it. With a family of five, that's not affordable. And so what Homeless to Homeowner is we're gifting people not a free house, but a home that they can have for the rest of their lives. That their family can have some, their children can have something and pass down to their children. That's what this is about. Having a better quality of life forever. And so some of the things that we have done, we do a lot of transitional housing. We have help with rental assistance and resources and things like that. And now what we're doing right now is getting a bus. I have a bus that I'm utilizing that I was talking to him about. And I know everybody, some people here have called AAA and had roadside assistance, right? And so what this bus is called, warm side assistance. And so what we do is we pick people up, homeless people that are on the concrete, laying down outside, and we pick them up in the bus and make sure that they're warm for at least 3 to 4 hours. Give them warm food, give them, you know, talk to them, spiritual guidance and things like that. Up to 4 hours if we have the space, because we have to go pick up other people. And that costs money. A bus driver costs money. Insurance costs money. To wrap the bus costs money. The food costs money. To make sure that they're warm costs money. All this costs money. So you all have been invited to a comedy show that is next Friday in East Point, the great city of East Point. And it's going to be at the East Point High School Auditorium at 8 o'clock. The doors open at 7. We have four local comedians, and one of the comedians is a veteran who experienced homelessness. That's how real it is. The people who fought for this country deal with homelessness too. People that have money deal with homelessness. Homelessness doesn't choose a person by race, education, or age, or gender. It just happens. That's how quick it happens. It deals with people with substance abuse, disabilities, veterans, all type of walks of life. So I'm asking everyone in here, everyone that has a home in here, that know how it feels to go in your house, turn on the fireplace, got 5 bedrooms, 2 bathrooms, some of y'all got a swimming pool, invite me over this summer, please. And it feels good to have a home. So let's make somebody else feel good to have one too. Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. Thank you for that. Next then today, what we're going to do is we're going to talk about the North Gratiot Cruz Foundation. And so the North Gratiot Cruz, anybody that's on the board, Tracy and Joe Baller and Brad, you, all the members of the board of the North Gratiot Cruz, come on up here for just a minute, if you will, please. Bob, you're as far as I'm concerned. So we do a cruise every year in Chesterfield. We established the cruise about 10 years ago. These are the support team for the cruise, and it's grown every year. And we've been able to raise quite a bit of money for Chesterfield and local causes in Chesterfield. And with this year's, what we're just about to go through here now with this year's contributions, you know, our cruise has raised about $100,000 for Chesterfield and the various causes in Chesterfield. So these are all the people here that have made all this happen and been the support team and have grounded out every day. And I wanted to give them special recognition today for what they do. Yeah. And I'm just going to tell you, so this guy here, Joe Baller, so when I first, he's, you know, Baller Towing, everybody. So when I first got involved with the crews out there at the time, Joe and I, we didn't hit it off so good. But we've gotten to be really good friends, and I admire Joe. The crews, as hard as the chamber works on the crews and all the volunteers here, he's really an integral. And so this past year with the crews, you know, Joe and I, the two old guys, were out there humping it out at the end of the day, you know, moving crap around and trying to figure out what we're going to do next, and kept talking to each other about we're getting too old. You know? But thanks, Joe, especially his company, for their great support of Chesterfield Township and that. So I wanted to just recognize all of these people here today. But the next part of the program, and then in regard to Chesterfield today, so we did have... you know, we had a rainy day that day. We had the first Chesterfield cruise, but a lot of it's finally the weather broke and it came off. And kind of our theory was, you know, we're not giving any money back to these sponsors. This cruise is going on no matter what. You know, and I want to say a special word of thanks to TLC Craig Cole here, please. And you all know Craig. And then Scott Marino from Penske Corporation. Thank you. And on your table, you have a listing of the cruise and the 5K, all of the sponsors. Special thanks to all of them for making the cruise happen. And so,
Well, I just want to say that since I've been working with the North Gratiot Cruise and Cruising 53, I couldn't do any of what I do without all these people. And when I say they step in, I don't have to ask. They just step in and they do it. And so to John's mention about the rain, we were like, oh my God, it's raining. And then it was pouring. And, you know, TLC became our presenting sponsor for our very first 5K, which supports the schools in the surrounding area. And I mean, when I say it was pouring, they shot that gun off and it was pouring, and we didn't see anybody, but even our sponsors, all of them that are listed here, they showed up and they set their tents up, and Bo had his hot dogs on standby. He said, I'm not starting these dogs until we see the sun come out, and the sun came out. I just wanted to say that I wanted to thank all of you and all of our sponsors, and I want to thank John, because without John being the lead, none of this would happen, and we never thank him enough. So thank you, John.
So thank you, Donna, for those kind comments. So first thing today, we have a check, and I guess, Brad, you might be the representative as the township supervisor for, where's David Joseph? Is he here? Dave, come on up. Okay, so our first contribution today is for the Friends of the Chesterfield Township Police Department. And Dave is actually, he's a trustee from the township and also to one of the founders of that organization. So we wanted to present a check to Friends of Chesterfield PD for $2,000. Right? Very good. And thank you, Dave, for that. Thank you so much for that. And then not to forget our friends in public safety in Chesterfield Township. The Friends of Chesterfield PD actually have their own nonprofit, but we wanted to do something for the fire department, and they don't have a particular organization. So we are making a contribution to We're actually buying several pieces of equipment for the fire department, and we're going to pay the bill on that. Dave, tell me what that equipment was again.
Yes, yeah, so John, I talked to Chief Miller, and what we have in the township are some handheld thermal imaging scanners that our firefighters use when they go on the scene. And it really helps to clear and make sure that the homeowner or the business owner has peace of mind that there are no additional hot spots in the building. So the chief has been experimenting with these. He has three on staff now, and because of your generosity, we'll be able to get three more. And he's very excited and appreciative
very
for
good.
That, John. So thank you.
Okay. Well, thanks for that. And Brad brought a check today for that vendor for the unit. So thanks for your help with that, Dave. And then next today, I wanted to recognize the Selfridge Chesterfield Lions. And Tracy is a volunteer with our organization, but she represents the Lions. And we have a check today for the Lions Club, the Chesterfield Lions, for $1,000. And then the 5K that we have in as part of our event, kind of how our 5K works is the school district that comes with the most runners, they get a $1,000 contribution to their athletic program. And we already did make the contribution to the Anchor Bay High School athletic program for $1,000. And then we have here with us today Kathy Vosberg, from the trustee from Chesterfield, and you're the lead of the Historical Society. And Kathy's a long friend and former county commissioner, and we've worked together quite a bit through the years. So I called Kathy. I said, hey, you know, I don't know what to do about this Historical Society. Well, I'm the person, and she's here today. So we have $1,000 for the Historical Society. Thanks for your work. And then the next three items, I'm not sure that we have a particular representative, but we'll present this to the supervisor. And so we have $1,000 for the Chesterfield Senior Citizen Program. And we have $1,000 for the Chesterfield Library Building Fund. And then we have $1,000 for the Chesterfield Veterans Memorial. So that all came about as a result of our work with the crews in the 5K. So anyhow, thank you for all your help, and I'm eager to work with you even more closely. Now, I lived in Chesterfield for a while. I left Chesterfield, but I couldn't take it, and I had to come back. So they got to put up with me. So I'm eager to work with you even more so in the future. Thank you all for all you do. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you.
Yeah, you got it. And then last but not least today, as part of our program, I want to bring up Todd Stamper from Priority Waste. Todd, if you'll come up. So they're a big supporter of the chamber. Todd and I are friends for many years. I've actually worked with Todd and his family and his dad, Ken Stamper, for many years. Stamper Management, many of you know them. And then Todd is a real entrepreneur, and he's been off doing all kinds of things, including establishing Priority Waste here the past couple of years. But I do government relations work with Priority Waste. They're a great company. They're about giving back to the community everywhere that they are. In fact, when Todd and I first spoke about me working with his company, it was kind of like, well, you know, we need some guidance in terms of giving back to the community and making a difference, and would you come on board? And I said, well, I'll work for you a little bit, but I'm not working for you full time. That ain't happening.
Thank God it worked out that way.
Yeah, and it's been a pleasure, and virtually everything that I bring forward to Priority Waste, Todd's always there. They're really giving. They have their own foundation, he and his wife, Pauline, and they do really great stuff in the community. And they're here, right here in Clinton Township, as their corporate offices. Really growing company, a lot of employees. Coming up on 4 years here now.
Yep, just almost 4 years.
And I really enjoy working with Todd and Priority, and Todd is just really a great dynamic leader. No, he hates it when I say this, but he really is. I really admire Todd.
I told you, flying.
Yeah, I admired Todd a great deal, but Priority Waste today is going to make a number of contributions, and So I saved them for last. And so one that we're going to do today for priority is the New Baltimore Civic Club. We have a check for them, Dave, if you're still here, for $500. And then let's do, next is the Warren Community Foundation. Big support of the Warren Community Foundation. Priority Waste, $5,000 to the Warren Community Foundation. And then the North Grasha Cruz Foundation, Priority Waste, is giving $5,000 to the North Grasha Cruz Foundation. And Laura, if you're still here, but if not, $3,000 for the New Baltimore Lions Club. And then last but not least, we have a contribution for the Clinton Township Inclusive Playground. And we have a check today for that. So if you don't know what the Inclusive Playground is, for kids with disabilities, effectively. And we have our representative today from there. Forgive me, I'm sorry.
AnnMarie
Ottoy. She's the chair of this and the volunteer, and yes. You don't work for. We talked last night actually at the TLC event, and she doesn't work for the township, so this isn't like, well, I got to do this for the township. She's doing it because she wants to do it, and so we have a check today for $15,000 for the inclusive playground. So anyways. So that pretty much covers the landscape today. Thank you, Todd. Thanks for our advice.
Hey, how about John, guys? Getting us together.
Todd says, don't come back to me with any more stuff this year now.
John who?
Yeah. But I hope that you all enjoyed the luncheon today. I hope that, my role is to, as a chamber person, is to try to make things happen. But part of what we're doing is try to make difference in our community, far and wide, and to lead. And I hope that for those of you here today that saw so many of our volunteers and so many people and businesses and organizations that give, that you're inspired by that. And if you've been waiting around to figure out where to go or what to do, talk to the chamber or find some cause that you can, it doesn't have to be my cause, but that you can make a difference in your community. But we're glad to work with anybody, and I hope that you go out today after this and say, I want to make a difference in our community. I want to make a difference in the lives of other people, and that we're going to lead in that regard. So God bless you all. Thank you all for coming today. Have a wonderful holiday. Thank you.